Whether it's microinverters or power optimizers, the type of solar inverter you select is a key decision when you design your solar array. So let's compare these two types of solar inverters and help you confidently select the best one for your home or business. So Larry, before we jump into it, let's talk about the differences between a microinverter and a optimizer setup.
So these are essentially two different technologies that do basically the same thing. So they're both module level power electronics, which means that they pull the maximum power out of each module.
Yeah.
They monitor the module level, they mitigate shade at the module level. So they do a lot of the same things. The key difference, Warren, is that the microinverter is up under the solar module, and that's it. The microinverter does everything. It does the maximum power point tracking, and it does the conversion from DC to AC. The optimizer is different. The optimizer is up under the panel to do the maximum power point tracking, monitoring, reporting, and all that. And then the inverter is still hanging on your wall, which converts it from DC to AC. So that's the main difference between the two technologies.
All right, Larry. So I went through this decision process myself, deciding whether or not to go with optimizers or microinverters. And I made the decision to go with microinverters. And there were some challenges, and there's been some pros and cons. So let's talk about them. What do you think some of the pros and cons of microinverters are?
So some of the pros for microinverters is that everything's up under the roof.
Right.
The whole inverter.
Yeah.
Now, you're still going to have a box on the side of your house, probably not quite as big as an inverter. It's going to, you know, it's going to combine your strings, and it's going to be your monitoring, your source to get the data from the microinverter to the internet,
right?
The gateway for that. So you're still going to have that, but the whole inverter is up under your module. The other cool thing about microinverters is you have 100% design flexibility. You can do one microinverter, you can do 2,000. It doesn't matter because it's putting out AC power.
Right.
You don't need to worry about, well, how many strings. How many modules per string. You still need to worry about modules per branch circuit, but you can do one up to infinity,
right,
as far as your complete design. On the con side, one of the main cons that I would say is that you're moving power at a lower voltage. So typically with power optimizers, you're moving at a higher DC voltage. With microinverters, you're moving power at 240 volts AC, which is a lower voltage, which means a little bit higher losses and a little bit bigger wire. The other thing that I would say is a con is that typically microinverters require specific accessories for their system. So you need to use their wiring, you need to use their branch circuit end cap, you need to use their combiner, you need to use their gateway, that type of thing. So that tends to be a little bit more costly because of that. And then the final con that I would say with microinverters is any replacement of the inverter, you're lifting a module.
Sure.
You got to get up on the roof, you got to lift a module, pull that microinverter out and replace it. That's no matter what.
Sure. But that's partly true with optimizers.
Correct.
If it's not the inverter and it's the optimizer, they're still housed under the panel.
Same thing. Exactly.
So let's talk about power optimizers and some of the comparisons there, or the pros and the cons.
So there, I would say the main pro is that they're moving power to higher voltage DC, which means that's more efficient. They also don't need those accessories that we talked about. The other pro is that, like we mentioned, you can replace the inverter. The inverter's at ground level, so if you need to replace it, you can replace it without getting up on the roof. To your point, if the optimizer fails, you still got to get up on the roof. So, you know, that's, I would consider that a pro because some of the electronics are at the ground level, easier to replace. However, on the flip side of that, because you have one inverter,
right?
If that inverter fails, your whole system's out.
Right.
Versus a microinverter, if one fails, just that one micro's out. So it's kind of a pro, kind of a con. Another pro with an optimizer system, Warren, that's a little more complex, a little bit harder to understand, is that I can more efficiently use my inverter power if my system's not as optimal. I'll give you an example. So let's say I have an east and west facing roof.
Right.
So, and I have a 1.5 ratio, DC to AC ratio, which means I'm going to have more clipping. With a microinverter system, I'm just stuck with that 1.5 all day long. I have full sun in the east, and it's clipping that power, and then I have full sun in the west, and it's clipping that power in the afternoon.
Right.
If I have one inverter, one centralized inverter for the whole system with my optimizer system, and it's at a 1.5 ratio, I'm at full power in the east in the morning, but not much power in the west.
Right.
In the afternoon, I'm at full power on the west, but not much power in the east. So I don't, I'm not clipping as much throughout the day, even though I'm at the exact same DC to AC ratio. So a lot of systems, it's not going to matter. If it's south facing, typically it's not as big of an issue. But if it's a more complex, maybe not as optimal system, I can use my inverter more effectively with an optimizer system than with a microinverter system in some cases.
So in those unique situations, there's some efficiency gains with power optimizers over microinverters.
Right, and they're small. It's not like it's 10%. It might be a percent or two.
Sure, sure. You know, for me, Larry, one of the key decisions, and this was several years ago, in going with microinverters as opposed to power optimizers, was at that time, the microinverters had a substantially longer warranty. And that's no longer the case. Today you can get warranties of 25 years, both with power optimizers and with microinverters.
Right, right. So historically, the microinverter was always 25 years. I say always, for the last decade, 25 years. And the power optimizer was also 25 years, but the inverter that goes with the power optimizer was 12 years.
Okay, yep.
Now, like you said, you can extend that inverter all the way to 25 years, so you can get a full 25 on whatever you're doing. Now, another thing I'll mention with that is typically with microinverters, your gateway, which is your device that takes the data from the microinverter and projects it to the internet, your gateway typically only has maybe a 2-year or a 5-year warranty.
Right.
So that's something to watch out for. Whereas with an optimizer system, all your main components, your gateway is included in the inverter, so all your main components can have up to 25
years. Yeah, that's something to be aware of for sure. All right, Larry, so now we've talked about really the fundamental differences between power optimizers and microinverters. What about, how do they differ or compare in terms of the installation process?
Well, believe it or not, Warren, that's very similar.
Yeah.
In both cases, you've got a device, a smaller device up under your module, whether it's a microinverter or a power optimizer. And in both cases, you have a device on the side of your house.
Yeah.
Now, the device on the side of your house with an optimizer is going to be a little bit bigger because that's the inverter.
Right.
Whereas with the microinverter, it's probably going to be a little bit smaller. It's just a combiner and your gateway. But you still have a lot of the same components. Another difference, small difference again, is that with microinverters, you're going to have, typically going to have the cabling from the manufacturer that you have to install up on the roof versus just regular wire with the optimizer system, but very, very similar.
Okay, and in terms of reliability, how do they compare?
Again, very similar, and this comes and goes over time.
Yeah.
You know, manufacturers, they have issues, they fix them. So, you know, if you'd asked me 10 years ago, I would have said optimizers are way more reliable. If you would have asked me 3 years ago, I would have said, you know, microinverters are way more reliable. It kind of comes and goes. Both technologies are getting better. And it manufacturers in both technologies are improving their processes.
Yeah, and so, I've experienced that firsthand. When I first installed my system five years ago, whenever it was, I had five microinverters fail within the first 90 days. And it was a known defect, which was repaired. And since then, haven't had any issues.
Yeah, yeah. So they both have a high reliability.
Right.
It's just both of them are constantly trying to improve their processes.
Yeah, yeah, super. And then in terms of monitoring, being able to see how the system's performing, how do they differ?
Again, I mean, they're very similar. They're both monitoring all the same, information from the module. They're both monitoring output. You can see daily, monthly, yearly, lifetime. So very, very similar.
All the way down to the module
level. Yep.
Yeah. And then costs, how do they differ?
So this is a lot more similar than it used to be.
Yeah.
Optis used to be quite a bit cheaper than the micros, but that's changed. I would say typically the Optis are cheaper overall. Oftentimes the micros might be cheaper in just the equipment cost, but then with the microinverters you have to buy the accessories and the gateway and some of those extra pieces. So overall, very close. Optis are going to probably be a little bit cheaper, generally speaking.
So if you're a homeowner and you're looking to put something on your roof and you're debating between micros or optimizers, how would you know which one to pick, or does it really matter?
I would say it's primarily a preference. Generally speaking, if you've got a house roof and your meter's right on the side of the house, everything's right there, it's going to be very similar.
Yeah.
If you have a ground mount, or your solar is farther away from the interconnection point, then I would probably lean toward optimize. Or if you have a unique situation, east and west facing roof, then I would probably tend to lean toward optimizers in those cases.
So just to recap, the microinverters and optimizers, very similar, similar applications. Microinverters, you have the inverter underneath the panel, and it's sending AC current directly to the communication box and then into your house, versus the optimizers are sending DC current more efficiently in DC at a higher voltage back to the inverter where it's converted, which can be placed anywhere on the side of your house as well. Really, very similar options, could both work great in residential applications. If you have an east or west facing roof, or if your interconnection point is further away, you might want to go with Optis. Otherwise, they're very similar options. Let us know what you think. Now that you know the difference between microinverters and power optimizers, leave a comment in the comment section below and let us know which one's the winner. Larry and I recently had an opportunity to tour Enphase, which is one of the leading microinverter manufacturers, to do a tour and find out exactly how microinverters are manufactured. We had an incredible time. It's an incredible video. So if you want to watch that, we'll leave a link in the description below.
In addition, we also have a video where we went in depth on some of the top solar inverter brands. And if you'd like to check out that video, we'll link that in the description below as well.